can, it'll go pretty quick to start rolling some of these trusses here. Pretty much bring them to where they go, stand them up, we'll nail them into here, and then this is a little even more secure. And then I have, you know, put them where they go and spread them with a little piece of 1x2 with a nail that'll hold them on, you know, hold the top cord where it's supposed to be, and we can proceed from there. So you remember I said I had to set my end. So that's what I'm doing. I put my end exactly, you know, this way, the way I want it, and then he can go ahead and nail his end wherever he wants. A couple nails go in one direction, a couple nails in the other direction. Then I'll put a nail in this little wrap run, or whatever you want to call it, holding these together. Didn't take much. These don't have to, I mean, they're all going to be tied together pretty quick. If it's really windy or something, you might have to add a couple more. Worst thing in the world would be to not get this thing sheeted and then show up in the morning and have all the, you know, trusses laying over. Wouldn't be the first time that's happened. So we'll go ahead and run one more, then I'm going to brace off that gable the way it's supposed to be braced and all it's been. Okay, so this is what I was talking about, getting a brace on this gable. You know, right now all the exterior walls are tied, you know, they're braced off. So, anywho, I want to take this brace all the way into this top cord, or I'm sorry, the bottom cord of this gable truss. A couple nails in there. Lock it in place. Now I'm gonna have to lay this out just like the trusses are laid out. And then I'll nail, you know, we'll get it centered up in there real nice, and I'll nail it down on layout. Then I'm going to fabricate myself a brace, and I want it to go roughly 45 degrees. And the way I'll figure that out, the brace is gonna go to the bottom of this wrap run, we'll call it, as high up to the peak as I can get. I'm going to come off to the side of this longest stud in the gable wall. So I'll cut that profile on one end, and then I'll run it down to here. Actually, I'm not sure I like the way I have that set up. But anyway, I'll nail it into the side of here, and that will eventually lock this. Actually, what it's doing is locking this exterior wall. So imagine this, right now that wall is braced, it can't move. I'm going to put this brace across all these trusses and go from the top of the gable down here to the bottom of all these trusses. So without any roof sheeting on there, all these can still wiggle waggle. But by the time the roof is sheeted, this top cannot move. It's locked to the bottom, if you can follow that. Therefore, a brace from here angled down to there locks the middle of this wall in to where it cannot move. That's how you brace this exterior wall. You know, sometimes you might wonder, well, how does that wall not wobble? Well, because it's got a brace going from the roof sheeting basically down to the bottom cord of these trusses. They're all tied to that exterior wall, locked in place. Can't move. Okay. So here we are. We got. All the trusses rolled until 8 foot from the end. Then we flipped that other gable around, got it sheeted, put the lookouts on it, put the house wrap on it, put the barge on there. It's all ready to stand. And we will stand that up. I'm not gonna bother temporarily bracing it off. We'll have Austin just hang on to it. We'll slide another truss over to it and get them nailed together. That'll hold that end up, then we can fill the last two in and just brace off the bottom and make it plumb like we want, all in one shot. Do have a little situation where the interior walls are a little bit high. The trusses are riding on them, not enabling us to get the ends down all the way. So apparently this pony wall in the middle is built a little bit high. That's okay. But I may, you know, Austin's going to be holding that. He can hold it. He's a strong guy. But I might have to kerf out the top of those plates a quarter inch or something to allow those trusses to sit down enough where they'll bear on the outside wall. Anywho, it up, rest of the trusses in here. Then we'll have to work on putting the fascia on and the bird blocks on, and I can explain what that is. And then we'll put our overhang plywood all the way around, and then we can sheet the roof, and then we call it macaroni. I don't know, it's getting warm. I don't know how far we'll get, but we'll get this up, we'll get all of them in position, and work on the fascia, get them certainly secured before we would go home for the night, and finish it tomorrow. Okay, so we're putting the fascia on. Fascia's, you know, where you attach the gutter to. It needs to be in a particular place on the end of these tails. I've done all the calculations. If I did it all right, everything should nail together and be just aerial straight and level. I don't want to run the inside of this fascia up to the top corner, I'll call it corner, of the cut end on this top cord. I want it so that when the plywood is laying on here, it comes to the outer edge of this fascia. So when I plane down, it is either hitting on the middle of the fascia or a little bit outside. It depends on the roof pitch, but what that ends up usually looking like is I could go about a quarter inch down. So when I look at this, and you can't see this, but when I look at it, I see a quarter inch of the cut end of that rafter, and that plane, that everything will plane correctly if that is the case. So anyway, I have laid this all out. I like to do that. I've laid the fascia out so I can shove the tails one way or another and make sure the spacing is correct. Right now they're probably able to move this way and that, and I can shove them wherever I want them usually. Anyway, it's nice to have that laid out and make sure it's right.